personal identity. You're putting that in there. Ugh, what a beautiful inside. Again, don't tear up your mom's pictures without asking her. All right, we got Ronnie's identity box here. Mr. Miguel Tejas makes an appearance, right? And all the part things that are a part of your internal identity. Don't, maybe like special memorabilia goes inside. Again, you're going to take pictures of this and you're going to post it to Google Classroom. Next, right? I think we already saw this photo. Next. So check it out, right? Notice everyone's identity box looks different, right? We have pets. That can be a part of you. Family is everything, memories, beliefs. It's all part of your identity box. So as you're seeing this video, I want you to write down ideas. Ideas that you're going to have. All right. Ooh la la, a baby shoe. I love it, right? So like you're looking around the house for special items that bring you back. These are the beautiful things about you, like that no one knows. Marathon, we got some SRLA stuff happening. Concert tickets, again, a lot of photos. Again, the outside, right? Could be a pattern. Maybe people see you as like fragile, a beautiful flower, and that's part of your external identity. But we go inside, and we learn so much more. Next, all right. I like this for external identity because sometimes we think people are just quiet, you know, right? That's all we know about them. They're quiet and shy, right? Maybe you know their name, the fact that they're 16. So here she's writing about all the things that people know about her, right? Or the assumptions that people make about her, but they don't really know her. And then when you look inside, there's something different. Okay, another great shot. This is outside of the box. I think this was
Clemens. I stopped the video around here. She's getting along.
So everyone, you're answering these questions. Like, what is the purpose of this identity box? Like, everyone's done a good job, like, explaining what they're seeing. But like, how can this benefit you? Like, you're like, this is an art class. Why am I making a box about my identity? It's like, why do you think that's helpful?
So Miss, I can unmute myself and talk right now, right?
Yes, you're always.
I'll get a ton of points. Like, you know, so Jose and Lionel and I, it's my arguing some points. We're going to really get the points. I would describe the why, right?
Why? Yes. Martin posted, he said, it is a project that represents accomplishments that made you happy and the person you are today. That could be a part of
it. So guys, come on. This is a Friday. You got to get snappy. You got it. Like, why? Why are we doing this? What are the benefits? Could this save a life? Come on, guys. We want you to unmute yourself. Okay, you guys got to go deeper than that. Come on. So why would this doing this be especially good for teenagers and especially important for teenagers? Like really going, this is goes beyond the heart map. This is a 3D heart map. Like how could this help someone? Can you guys unmute yourself, please?
Melanie Cruz is coming in.
One, Miss.
So, Martin, what do you think would the benefits of doing this box be? Doing this project, what do you think the benefits would be?
Well, I think it would benefit yourself, your visual identity to certain people around the campus, or even just people's opinion about you in general, or it can boost self-esteem. Personally, I like the way the boxes seem very heartfelt.
So how would it boost someone's self-esteem? You scroll up, Miss, I'm also giving points. How would it boost someone's self-esteem?
Well, I mean, it's because it's almost like kind of like showing yourself off in a way that you're allowing people to see you for who you are.
So what do you mean? Like, I can't see people right now? Like,
no, but it's more of it's confidence.
Very good. Other folks?
Melanie says maybe they see what it looks like and can relate.
Yeah, what, Melanie, would this create more unity and therefore less war? I guess that's my big question. Like, could this project lead to less destruction, less war, less misunderstandings if more of us turned ourselves inside out like this? Melanie Cruz, you're on live. Anyone? Would the world be better if we were looking at everyone's internal identity more?
Melanie says, yes, we can show our true selves.
But why would the world be better if everyone was showing their true selves?
Jose said, that's bad.
Why? So we can actually see what goes on. I need some people to unmute themselves and actually talk. This is your class. Would the world be good? Better? Would we be happier? If more of us, if we judged each other more based on internal, or would there would be maybe no judgment?
I think that if we went based on personality, it would be better because, you know, like, it's like who you are on the inside and, like, who you truly are. What are your feelings? What are your likes and dislikes? And, like, you know, on the outside, it's so, like, based and like, just, like, really judgmental. And you don't really know what's going on inside or who is actually that person.
Like, we're focusing on what's the other. Like we other people. Like, we focus on differences when we focus on external, but aren't we more similar than we realize, Melanie Cruz, or anyone? Are we more similar? Do we all have,
I feel like we are. It's just that, like, we just need to give a chance to see who we truly are.
We need to give a chance. Do we all agree? Does anyone agree with anything that's been said? Are people here? Are people with us? You need to feel an urgency with this project. Do you agree? You agree? Why do you agree? Do we all have memories? Do we all have a history? Do we all have a story? Have we all been through it? Why do you agree? Oh my gosh. Guys, unmute yourselves!
Yeah, Melanie made a point about how it's hard to show your true self. So it goes both ways. Like, people need to see your internal self, but to do that, you need to show them your internal self, right?
Or even know yourself.
Yeah.
You guys think you know who you are, yes or no? Do you know your beauty? Write in the chat. No. Jose says yes. Okay, it's 1-1. Okay, so it's 2-1. Do you know yourselves? Or is there more to you that you don't know, Jose, Rachel? Maybe there are another layers. Maybe there are other layers that you're not facing. What do you think? Do you know yourselves? Yes or no? Write it in the chat. I know plenty, but not all. So we got now 3. Now it's 3-2. I'd say no. Thank you, Jesus, for joining class. I saw you on the deck too. Thank you. Unmute yourselves.
Raymond says yes.
Melanie says there's more that she needs to discover. We're 4-3. I mean, isn't it a problem how, like, kids are always like, don't expose me, don't expose me. Aren't we supposed to expose ourselves? Like, isn't there something wrong with, like, not exposing? If we miss people, you could go through your whole life, not know who you are, and not know who's around you. You live, you die in a bubble, and that's it. And maybe, did you ever, like, become and grow into the person you were supposed to be? Oliver, do you know yourself? Okay, miss, sorry, I completely took over. You want to explain the difference between internal and external?
I think we needed that. We need some people to start thinking, start talking. Do you know yourself, miss?
I don't know who I am. I have no idea who I am. I don't know.
Yeah, it's always been very intimidating to me. Oh, Brian. In my opinion, I say I don't necessarily know myself because I may know my interests and attributes, but not necessarily my whole internal self.
Giving you a bunch of points for that.
I think there's a lot more layers than we realize. I'm like, I think this project helped me, like, going through it already, like, just brainstorming with other classes has helped me, like, actually take time and think about my internal self, right?
Yeah, like, don't we lose ourselves?
Yeah, with our daily tasks, we're, like, just trying to get through every day, and, like, we don't really think about other things that are more deep or internal. There's some stuff we haven't discovered that may take your whole life to do, says Lionel.
Right? So to know yourself is the greatest journey of all. Like, that's the beginning of all wisdom. That's what Socrates said. That this is the beginning of your life. We're asking you to begin your life by doing this box. So again, can doing this box save your life? That's what you need to think about, because I want you to feel urgency. All right, miss, I'm gonna calm down.
Feel the urgency, everyone. Feel the energy. I can feel Miss Copera's energy from the screen. This box is exploding right now. My laugh makes me happy. I want to hear it, so unmute. Okay, so these are just past examples of projects from other AJR students. And you can see, like, on their external, so the outside of the box, like we saw in the video, they wrote keep out, like, this is my stuff, like, keep out, this is private, this is personal. They wrote their names and just obvious things. And maybe, like, a group of friends that you're always with. Those are things that people could, like, see about you. And you could write, like, your age. This looks like a medical chart, kind of. It's, like, very plain, and it has all this information, like, what you look like on a piece of paper, I guess. Like, where you live, how old you are, how tall you are, where you were born. And internally, they have more of these detailed photos and objects and memories and passions over here, and, like, the secrets box, like, I cannot, oh, I don't think I've had access, but let me see if I can, I cannot zoom. Okay, their secrets box, like, it shows, like, this box that is labeled secrets, but, like, we don't know what's inside, right? Like, you don't have to tell us what your secrets are, but, like, that's, like, facing that you have secrets, and it's, like, not always meant for everyone to see, but, like, they're there. Own your own secrets, face them, ponder them. I like that word, ponder. And this is another example of a student who did work where, like, is everything black and white? Like, do you all believe everything's black and white? Or do we have gray?
Jose, can you unmute yourself? I want to hear your passion. Like, it's stuffed either one thing, or you're either this or that. What's wrong with that thinking? No, color expresses feelings. Matt, can I hear your voice? Look, I said I was going to calm down, and look, I'm so bad. But Ms. Sibler, maybe you speak to this. Was the artist making a statement that supports Jose and Matt's passion?
Yeah, I think so. Like, you guys are both writing in all caps, so, like, we can tell you're, like, you have an opinion on this. So, like, let us hear your voice. Like, we can, like, tell you what we think, but only you can tell us, like, what you're feeling, what you're thinking. Like, I don't want to put words in your mouth, so. Okay.
I think we're losing some of them. I haven't heard from, like, a lot of the class. Let's keep rocking and rolling. Yeah, so this is the inside of their box. So something to keep in mind is you guys need to have 3D objects. So over the weekend, begin to collect what you're gonna gather. So let's test them, Miss, on whether or not they understand the difference between Oh wait, should we share what we would put in our box?
Oh yeah.
All okay. Right. You're on, Miss.
One example of an object that I could put in my identity box is this spike. It goes in the bottom of your shoe and, like, it gives you traction when you run, like, it digs into the ground. So this is a huge part of my identity because I started running 7 years ago now. And at first I was terrible at it. I hated it. But, like, by the end of my track season, I was like, I really want to be good at this. Like, I want to be good enough to wear spikes and, like, earn spikes. And it took me, like, 3 years to finally get to where I want to be. But I think that was, like, the first time that I, like, put my mind to something and decided that no matter how hard it got, I was going to finish it through and actually get better and, like, make myself proud. So that's become a huge part of, like, running has become a huge part of my identity, and it's taught me so much in life.
Guys, write on your pod what you're learning. Okay. This is my class ring. I moved it over, Miss.
Okay.
This is my class ring. From the class of 2001. So the thing's 20 years old and it's all scruffed up. But on the inside, if it wasn't, you could see an art palette. So there's a paintbrush underneath the jewel. So even when I was in high school, art was super important to me. Right? You could kind of see on the inside. My daughter says I need to fix it. And on one side, you see my name. Right, Rachel, which is part the greatest name ever, right, Rach, which is part of my external identity, but like my internal identity, you could see drama masks. Ooh, that's the most in focus it's been. So there's drama masks and there's a stage. So art, drama, really important to me. And I still wear this ring because it was at this high school when I was in 10th grade that I remembered or I decided that I was going to be an art and drama teacher because I was like, man. Where I'm really seeing like these subjects help kids. Like I could see that art and drama was really saving kids and helping kids to find a voice. So I decided then, so I wear this to remember my why and where I was when I decided. I also met my husband at this school. So thank you everyone for writing on Nearpod. Thank you, Matt and Leonel. So those are just two things we would put in our identity box. Two, think about, that's just like the beginning. There are stories beyond objects. So what would you put in your box? So go ahead, like, think about that. Write on Nearpod what you learned about us. I'm gonna get points. I'm gonna be quiet. I have not heard from Noah, Aldair, Irvin today. I haven't heard from Oliver. Did I hear from Michael Ponce?
Jonathan Santa Cruz is joining now.
Okay, I'll mark him as late. Can you let him in?
Yeah.
Okay, but what'd you learn about us? Okay, Ms. Copera has always had a passion for art. Points for Jamie. Okay, so Leonel says that Miss Hibbler fought for her achievement. She had a goal and she fought for it. And it's not just like, it's not just Miss Hibbler's a runner, but it's a story about when she became a fighter, right? We're going deeper. We're going beyond the surface. Like what has she overcome? Objects have stories. Miss K is flexing her ring. No. What did you learn about me based on the symbols in the ring? Miss Hibbler loves to run. She earned her tracks. Miss Copera always had a passion for art and drama. She wears the ring to this day, and she also met her husband in this high school. That was very thorough, Melanie Cruz. Mm-hmm. All right, miss, let's keep it rolling.
Okay. So guys, I think we're posting.
Yeah, hit enter because she's about to go to the next one.
Yeah. Okay. I hate it when the stop share button is right above like where I need to click. I know if I click there, it's not. What's up, Jose? It's also faster to unmute. All right, we're clicking next. Okay, so this is the start of a whole new unit. It's facing history and ourselves because you made your own history. So you are going to start by creating a brainstorm. So make sure you have your notebooks ready or your watercolor if you did those. And if you didn't, no worries. And a writing utensil. And we're going to be going through and talking about different parts of our identity through this brainstorm. So make sure you have this deck open too, because it'll give you a lot of ideas and sentence starters. So just to make sure we're all on the same page, everyone is going to take a moment and write on Nearpod. Adriana's coming in, miss.
I got her.
Okay. So you're going to write your external identity in green on the outside of this figure. So things that people know about you just by looking at you, or like maybe just by seeing you. So your name, your gender, your race, your age. You can only, like, you can just choose one to three of these and write about them. So green on the outside, all about your external identity. What do people, like, what assumptions do people even make about you? And then internal identity, you can write it in blue on the inside here. So what are your priorities? What do you like or dislike? Who do you love? Who do you miss? What makes you happy? What challenges do you face or have? And what do you need? What makes you proud? What okay, your story is?
Sorry, we gotta go to the next one so they can draw.
Oh, sorry.
Oops, I clicked the arrow. Oh, we can both control it. That's so cool. So guys, like, just like, you're gonna like write one or two things like on this, right, miss?
Yes. Sorry, I thought it was open the whole time.
And I was all like,
hurry up.
So go ahead, draw. Just show us, you know, the difference between internal and external. Miss, I'm recording this so you can show people like that you did this lesson one day. It's gonna be awesome. You're like, and I can do this. Thank you, Lino, for being on task. Thank you, Jose. Points. Guys, you're not really in class unless you're doing classwork.
Hey, miss.
What's up?
Could you say that these videos are also a memory that has been just videotaped, kind of like that?
Mm-hmm. Oh, that we're like recording our memories forever together?
Yeah.
I know. I'm going to put this in your senior video. It's going to be weird because it's going to be just me and Miss Hibble. So maybe y'all should put your camera on so we get some memories. Thank you, Jesus. But yeah, I know, Maureen. That's so cute. I love how you're sentimental. That's a good thing. Thank you, Ismael. Thank you, Matthew. Thank you, Brian, for being on task. Thank you, Urban and Jose. Thank you, Matt. All the boys are on task. Where are the girls? Not all the boys. Melanie, you out there?
Adriana?
Yeah, guys, click the link. Click the link. So So you like your name, like you don't have to answer all these questions, just a few things to show us you understand the difference. Movie, I could see Jose moving them around. Thank you, Martin. Dun, 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 dun. So one thing that no one would know about me by looking at me, the first thing that I would put is I grew up without a mom. Like that is like a huge, like that really makes me who I am. And I would put that first. And I remember doing a project like this in high school and it saved my life. And it helped me to realize that that was like so central to like my goals. On the outside, like people see me, what do they think? They know my name's Lionel, boy, girl. Okay, thank you, Melanie. Any sort of memories and stories, your history. And then thank you, Lionel, for following instructions. So in the chat, you're explaining the difference between both. Ms. Sibler, what did Lionel say?
Lionel said, external is the mask we put on to not be afraid, but the internal is what we fight for and why we keep fighting.
I think that's like huge. That's so deep.
It is deep. And Martin said, the difference between internal and external is that internal is mentality and the other is more of what you will express. Yeah, I mean, I think we can still express ourselves through our external identity. It's just people see that before they see what's actually on the internal side and like can make judgments based on it. And yeah, internal. Sorry, miss.
I just thought of something, like by doing all the work of understanding your internal identity and like making your identity box so beautiful and layered, you as a person are going to be less judgmental. Right? You're not going to value the external shell as much because you know yourself. By knowing yourself, you begin to really see beauty in others and see real beauty and escape society's prison. Bam. Can I put a star in the box? You guys can put anything on the box. There's no limits. Just keep it appropriate. Keep it. You're not annoying, Jose.
We always appreciate questions.
Well, you're getting me through this pandemic. But if you've heard someone call you that, like Ladis, you see her example. She says, like it says rude really big on the outside her box. Like if people have called you names, you know, or made assumptions about you, that's kind of like, that's a part of your external identity that you're trying to get rid of. All right, miss, we can leave this open, I think, and I can play. I think I need to share screen to play the video. I'm gonna temporarily share screen. So you can guys keep writing there, but I have this video, unfortunately. So everyone make sure you're writing right now and setting up your box.
What should we do, ground rules?
Oh yeah, do ground rules. Yep. Mm-hmm. 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 Yep. Yes.
Okay, so today we're going to have our cameras on and you can point it down like you have your journal ready or the watercolor paper you did. Just have that open, have that out. You're going to be writing in your journal all these circle maps.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And you're not worrying about spelling or grammar or perfecting what you're writing, or like even you're not even writing in complete sentences. Like you're just writing down all your thoughts. Like this is like, what is it? Writing flow. Just going for it. Write the truth. You're going to try and fill up the whole page. And today is just a start. So we're just starting this out today, not taking too much time, so you can go back and add more later. We're just getting you all thinking about this. So let's go ahead and start making our circle maps.
Yep, and everything's in the deck. Everything's in the deck.
All right, guys, so this is what you're setting up in your journal. So on one page, you're writing my...
Everyone do this right now.
Intellectual...
Mr. Rivera were here. He would say, do it now.
Identity.
Get out your journal.
I will show you this video in a second, period five. But I want to do this. And then you're going to make a big circle map. All right, and you're gonna use up this space. Next one, you're gonna write, look, my spiritual identity. Circle. Make your circle map big. Look, it doesn't need to be perfect. This is where I'm at, guys. Can you let Martin in, Miss Hibbler?
We know you're in line. That's a different one.
For the next one, you are going to go ahead. You're going to write my physical identity. You can go neater than me. Get your markers out. You can make it pretty. And then the last page is going to be your emotional identity. And I actually meant to do this one third, but the order doesn't matter. My emotional identity. Maybe we'll save the best for last. My emotional identity. I will go over them again, Marilyn. That's why I'm doing this video. Okay. And then on the outside, you're going to write your frame of reference question is, what are symbols, objects, and photos that you can put in your box? So that's what you're going to write on the outside of the circle map. Symbols, objects, like things, photos, or art. So again, frame of reference, symbols. A symbol is an object or a thing. Pictures, symbols, objects, pictures, and this could be something like, you guys could even think elements of art on the outside, like textures. Okay, so this is what you should have, three circle maps.
So what on the outside of the circles, what will I include in my identity box to show this part of my internal identity? And you can list pictures that you want to ask me to print, but I need to know by next Monday. Just start to list the different objects you want to put in your identity box as you're writing, because it'll come to you. Put it down now. Certain people, things, books. So we're looking on Seesaw right now, Miss, to see that they started
this. So this is what you're setting up in your journal. So on one page,
And we're about to all start writing, so please get set up. So I'm just looking.
Easy points.
Yeah. What, Miss?
Jose asked, can I put a person inside my box? That would have to be a pretty big box. You can take a photo of a person and put it inside the box.
Obviously, photos of people are good. And I am seeing a ton of Seesaw posts. I'm just going through and I'm getting ready, but I'm not seeing anyone posting these circle maps. So I'm gonna click refresh again. Show us you're there. Have your camera on with laptop pointed down. Thank you, Jose. Okay, and we're gonna just go ahead. We're gonna get started, Miss. I'll let you share the screen. Do you want me to do music?
I got the music.
All right. Wow, Miss is on fire. All right, you're on, Miss.
Okay. Thank you, Martin, for being ready. Okay. So we're just going to go through and take like 4 to 5 minutes for each part. Your intellectual, spiritual, emotional, and physical identities. And I'll ask some questions and you, like, you can use those as a reference to answer. So let me start the music. Oh no. All right, let's go. Can everyone hear that?
And you should turn it down. Okay.
That?
A little lower.
A little lower.
That's good.
Okay. So for intellectual identity, what do you think about a lot? Like, what do you find yourself thinking about for a majority of your day? What questions do you ask about the world? Yeah, no pausing, just free-flowing writing on our papers. What subjects do you like? Why? Like, why are you drawn to these subjects? Are they fun? What makes them interesting? What makes you curious? Why? What do you believe about yourself? Like, how do you see yourself as a person? What do you believe about the world or other people, maybe? I remember cameras on, just pointed at what you're doing, like pointed at your work, and you get a floor today.
Thank you, everyone who's posted that they started. So we're doing this now. Don't stop writing.
What do you believe about friendship or love? What do you think about education? What do you believe about history? Yeah, there are no right or wrong answers. This is just like your free-flowing thoughts. And Miss, if I feel like I wrote something really personal and I don't want everyone to see it in Seesaw, can I like blur that out on my page? Yeah. So this is like just for you.
You're learning about yourself. You're facing yourself.
Sorry, I can't hear you.
You're facing yourself. Right now, you're looking at yourself.
What do you believe about politics? And on the outside of your circle, you're going to be writing a frame of reference. So like what visual metaphors or symbols, like what objects, like your ideas of what you can use to represent your intellectual identity.
So Miss, could I put like a book?
Yeah, you can like pick out a book that you really like.
Quote?
Or a quote that you believe. Harry Potter.
Put that book right in the box.
Yeah, so let's finish up our intellectual identity.
And but Miss, this is like just the beginning, right? They should keep adding on. So again, this is FireWrite 12, guys. So this is due next Wednesday, but we want to see a beginning now. Okay, Miss, take us to the next one. We're going to start the next one.
This next one is your spiritual identity. And that does not mean that you need to have a religion. Like, not having a religion can be your spiritual identity. Like, do you believe in spirits? Do you believe in a God? Are you an atheist? Do you believe in a higher power? Don't know how to explain it? What do you think about other religions? What do you think about the idea of God? What do you think about truth and religion? Do you believe everything that you hear? Do you have questions or doubts about religion?
Just like, if I don't go to church, but I feel the most complete when I'm in nature, like with trees and mountains, is that part of my spiritual identity? Like, if I feel the most complete and whole when I'm on a stage or looking into students' eyes, can I put that for spiritual identity?
Yeah, where do you feel connected? You can write about memories that you have related to religion.
Everyone who's writing nonstop, it's not too late to turn your cameras on or start this assignment if you just found your book. So important to do this.
And I think this is a little bit harder to like come up with, an actual metaphor or symbol for, because spiritual identity is so hard to like come up with an actual object for. So like, what metaphors or symbols could you use to like represent your spiritual identity? Yeah, you can use nature. So like Miss was saying, you can use like a leaf. Like, if you feel most complete or most connected when you're in nature, then yeah, you can use any natural object to like represent that.
I would say quotes too, or like photos of like memories of total goodness and innocence. Like even being in the ocean, a picture of you in the ocean. Keep writing.
All right, next we're going to move on to our emotional identity. So, and sorry, Miss, I can't always hear you when the music's playing because the volume is so low.
Just turn it down a little. But guys, this is emotional identity. You guys are teenagers. This one go hard. You gotta go extra because you feel things. So really don't let anything, hold anything back. Put your emotion zone. Who are you frustrated with? You're on, miss.
So what emotions do you feel on a regular basis? Why do you feel these emotions? Like, when you first wake up, what's an emotion you feel? As you're going through your day, what are emotions you feel? And do you let your emotions control you, or do you control your emotions? Who do you like? Who do you love? Why? You can make like a whole list of people who are important in your life. Who is in your inner circle? What helps you get in touch with your emotions? Does music help, or art, or writing? This song makes me feel emotional.
Yeah, who do you love?
How does AJR make you feel?
Who do you miss? Miss, are you typing in the chat? You may be private messaging.
What makes you happy? Sorry, I don't know if you said that already, Miss. I saw you talking, but I couldn't like hear what you're saying. My music volume and the Zoom volume is connected. But what makes you happy and what makes you sad? What makes you afraid? And when do you feel doubt? And why? What makes you feel angry? Yeah, what frustrates you? What are the stories of your life? Emails. See. And lastly, before we run out of time, describe your physical identity. And I think this one is also a hard one to face, like how we were talking about with our self-portraits. So let's see. Great. What do you think about your body? Like, what do you think when you look in the mirror? Yeah, we gotta face this. Like, what's a feature that you really like about yourself? What's a feature that you don't really like? Describe your appearance. Your eyes, your arms, your legs, your hair, your smile, your hands. And do they look like something, like do they look like your parents or your grandparents or your siblings? Like, do you see yourself, do you see yourself in them or them in you? Yeah, this class goes by so fast. What does your appearance represent to you? Or what does your physical self say about who you are? Do you feel strong? Do you feel fragile? And what are some symbols or metaphors you can use in your box to represent yourself? Like your physical self. And you're going to keep working on these. We're running out of time. So I'm gonna stop this. Yeah, our Friday classes are so short, so we're running out of time, but finish up your exit tickets and you have the weekend to work on finishing this up. Let's go to Nearpod.
Yeah, and everyone too, remember the self-portrait project isn't done. So I saw portrait work from Michael Ponce, Matthew, Jose, lots of encouragement for Jose. It's looking good. It's just time consuming. The thing about the grid is it will eventually look like you. You just have to maybe don't obsess over the folds in your shirt. Matt, make sure you get all the blobs in your face, like every little line. I would go a little lighter with your lines. Christian, I saw some work. So you're done with the portrait, so make sure, did you post it? Was that the final big one? Remember, it doesn't exist unless it's posted. So the portrait should be wrapped up. Remember, grid folks, you have extra time. But yeah, so Matt, that's a great start. But remember, you got to do a line around like every shape in the face, like every little bump. Right. But that's like a really, really good start. I like how you're using the post-it. Yeah. But like the shapes inside and underneath and all those shapes, all those blobs. I don't know, Miss, can you explain it in a better way?
Yeah, I could go like if you can look at the cursor right now, like you can see like all of this is a light value. And like, especially on this side of the face, you have a lot of values here. So you're going to have to like go in and like, that's like box H9, like right here. If you go to box H9, like you can start adding in like that bumpy value box right here. Mm-hmm. And like connect that down and like goes all the way down over here.
But it's so interesting how these projects go hand in hand, because it's the shadows and the little details that make us who we are externally. But internally, it's like all of our life stories and our history and our wounds and our tragedies. So the identity box, guys, is another self-portrait, except we're turning ourselves inside out. You need feedback? I think you are onto a great start. I don't see letters and numbers. Oh, there they are.
They're light.
Yeah. I think you're onto a great start. I would like go to your face. I feel like you're scared of doing your face. So I no, you're not. Okay, I would just keep going lighter, and you know, give yourself like a chunk of like 2 hours here and 2 hours there to work on it. You know, be patient with yourself. But it's good because you're like doing the lines like bumpy. That's gonna make it look more like you.
Miss, do you think you would recommend drawing in like all the features before going in with all these like line details for the value? Yeah.
Like sometimes, like if someone is wearing like a sweater with like spots or like a texture, you can get a little lost in doing that, right? So like it may drive you a little nuts, Jose, to try to get every detail in the sweatshirt. I would prioritize your detailed work for like your eyes, you know, and your nose, because you might be like, ah, and stop doing, I don't want you to stop. Like, does that make sense? Does that help you? I love this, Christian. Christian, are you not gonna do the grid?
It's still like a pop art style.
I know. It's looking awesome. I feel like he could even, like, you, Christian, you could take your pen and you could go on top of your eye in dark.
Yes, I don't think he's here.
What?
I don't think he's here.
Oh, thank you for saving me. Oh, miss, I'm tired after that. Guys, post that you did this.
So he said, someone draw me.
I know, that's so funny.
Nice. It's all labeled. Everyone's set.
Thank you, Melanie, for posting that you did this. Ooh, you should, oh, Jesus Peraza. What? You guys should check out Jesus's. Whoa. Bax, what, Oliver's talking.